Hey there, eXtv fans. This is Moose coming at you once again with another episode of Moose Tracks. I am sitting here looking at PL Upward, one of the more popular payload maps, and this week's UGC playoff series map. First of all, I'd like to congratulate all the teams in UGC for making it through the entire season, and as we start getting into playoffs here, I hope you all are as excited as I am, and I'm definitely looking forward to this week. I've always thought Upward was one of the better payload maps, just very well designed, very well balanced. So as I go through here today, I'm not going to be talking so much about locations and naming locations because a lot of people are already familiar with the map. Instead, I'm going to be talking about what the offense and defense should be doing as far as strategy and positioning and sentry locations, sniper locations, the things I usually look out for. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm sitting here in blue spawn as always. Three ways out, you can come up right, and that puts you out here a little bit farther forward, gives you a view of this left-hand side. You can push straight out the middle onto the cart, but that gives you poor visibility and it puts you low. Or you can come out here, out this left side, and come up here up the side of this rock face and end up here. Just gives you a little bit of height. That's really the only three ways you have to push out. Defense starts way back here in the red spawn, which is this building. Usually most defenses will get set up fairly backwards on this map, actually back here. You'll see a lot of teams will put a sentry gun here or back here, which is what was used by the winning team in the UGC All-Stars match. They put a sentry gun right back here, and it worked out very well for them. You might see a sentry gun down here, heavy medic combo again up here, maybe a soldier. Snipers like sitting up here on this this building. Some teams might even hide like a spy or a scout or a pyro back behind here, just looking for an ambush or whatever. They're fairly well protected. So a lot of teams might hide a ambush class back here. That's something to watch out for. The only other big feature of this portion of the map is this little flank area behind here, and that just gives you a way around this structure, and that's a way for both spies to utilize getting behind the teams. Be careful if you decide to push this way. Pyros can easily air blast you off this cliff. I've died that way a couple times. It's a little embarrassing, but whatever the pyro has to do to kill you, he'll kill you. So, offenses on this map, a couple things to remember: that the payload cart moves at its fastest at a 3x capture rate, so three bodies on the cart, or a scout and another person. You don't need to stack your entire team on the cart to get it moving faster. It won't move any faster than three people on the cart. Play to the objective. You definitely want to keep your cart moving at all times, because defense usually gets the uphill advantage at most times on this map. Your DM's definitely going to want to be strong. You're definitely going to want to push people ahead and clear out defenses as they come up. And be smart about pushes, utilizing those flanks, and keep the cart moving. So we've already talked about some of the positioning you'll see in this part of the map, and assuming that blue can make the cart this far, they move on to the second capture point, which goes through this tunnel, and once you leave the tunnel, the point's right there. Big feature on this is the hill or whatever. It gives the defense something high to sit on, but you also can't see the cart being pushed through the push underneath them from that spot. So there are a couple ways down. You could take this tunnel from the top of the hill down into the tunnel, or if you are brave, you can drop through right here and you'll land on this medium-sized health and ammo pack, and that also puts you in the tunnel. There's this bridge in the tunnel, just somewhere for defense to spam down on from another elevated location. Sentry positions, you might see something up on top of the hill here that guards both of the ways up. You might see something on this bridge in here. Sorry for flying through the wall there. You might see something. This is a very popular location for it. You might see a sentry up on this platform. Again, where it's just high above the cart, it's hard to spam. A lot of teams will put one right out here, right outside spawn, because then they can hide a dispenser right here and have their sentry gun and have respawn right there. Snipers like sitting right here because they can see halfway down the tunnel, they can see on top of the hill, they can see all sorts of locations. Flanking classes can utilize this cliff face or whatever. It comes right where that big health and ammo pack are, medium-sized health and ammo pack, and it climbs along the side of the cliff and wraps around behind this structure. Be careful again, it's very easy for a pyro to utilize that and air blast you right off if you're not paying attention, so be careful. A soldier can rocket jump from down here up to, say, the here and here and just get behind a pushing offense. Really not too much else to say. I think I've covered everything. There's a little health and little health medium-sized ammo pack in here. Another ammo pack, health pack back here on the first point I forgot to mention earlier. You can see both of those, ammo pack on the left, health pack on the right, and another ammo pack up top here. Sorry for forgetting those earlier, but the only other structure here is this little attic that can be spammed through. There's no glass in the window panes, so you can so if the defense has a sentry up on that platform, you can easily spam down with a soldier or a demo man and try to get some stickies or some rockets on that spot and try to knock that sentry down. After the blue team captures the second point, if they can capture the second point, the red loses their forward spawn. They come back and they spawn in the headquarters itself. You do not have to run all the way around. You can a lot of people will run all the way down this way thinking that's the only way out. A lot of them forget that if you leave the spawn up the top door here, you can take a right and drop right down right on the third point. So that's worth remembering. This is a fairly straightforward push. Blue usually has no troubles pushing up to at least the ramps. This little tunnel right here can be utilized by a spy just trying to get around the team, but is not very often utilized, so that's worth remembering, but you don't need to work your whole strategy around it. Getting up to this ramps is difficult because the red team can sit right here and lay down some serious spam on the cart, or they can utilize this structure and again just shoot rockets or stickies or the heavy can just shoot his minigun down at you. There's this flank around here that you can utilize to get around the defense and up into the barn, or you can push underneath the ramps in this on this walkway. Grab the ammo or the health pack. There's an ammo pack right there, and again, you are behind the red team. Red team is probably going to have a sentry somewhere like right here, where they can where it can cover both the left and the right entrances here, and the and this structure. You might see a sentry even in this barn, just again covering whatever flanks they can get. That's really about it. You just got to have if you're on offense, you really just have to have a strong offense and push the red team out. Snipers will like to sit here a lot of the time and shoot down. Be careful. I had a team in a scrim last night do this to us. We capped the third point, but then we got wiped, and the sniper, knowing that once you cap the third point, you get a forward spawn, the blue team, in this door. And the sniper, knowing that we had the forward spawn, was sitting right here. And this is a wonderful spot, because a lot of the team had to push through this, and he just had all the time in the world to just point and shoot whatever he wanted. So that's worth remembering. If you're the offensive sniper, hide back here and try to pick him off if he decides to utilize that spot. That's really about it for the third point. The fourth point gets a little bit more complex because there are so many ways up and down and in and out. first of all, if you've captured this point, the red team is now going to be primarily just holding right here on the final point. This is the objective of the blue team, to push the cart off that ramp and into the hole. So a lot of defenses will be centered right around this final point, just trying to keep the cart from going that couple last couple feet. This barn can be utilized to get around the defense. There's both a lower and an upper area. The lower area here has a big health pack, medium-sized ammo pack, and can be utilized to get around defenses either through these set of stairs or up here. That exits here as well as goes upstairs here, and that's just another route to try to spam out the sentry gun or wherever they have it. The other ammo or health pack up here. Sorry, I'm just tying up all my words today. This route also has a health and ammo pack and drops down right here. So that's all interconnected. It's like a big figure eight. It's hard to get up on the defensive catwalk here without going straight to their spawn. And the only way up top is either through this side, or if you're in red, just up this door. And once they've captured the third point, that this door closes off, so you can't get around the blue team. Sentry gun, a very common location, is right here on this catwalk, because it provides cover fire for most of the locations of the cart, and is hard to access. Sometimes you'll even see a sentry gun right around here being protected by these boxes. Again, it just it removes some of the blind spots this sentry gun location has, because the scout can crouch using the cart as cover and push the cart up a little bit without being seen by the sentry. This location can be spammed from a little bit farther out, but if you use those boxes, it's harder to do that, and it's got fewer blind spots, especially along this track. You'll probably see a heavy and a medic holding right here, way up close, where they can see the lower, upper, and forward pushes. Snipers are kind of limited. You might see one right here, just trying to get as much of a visual as he can on the offense. On offense, speed is key, or whatever. You don't want to have let the defense get a full defense set up, or it's going to be a really long fight. Demo men will sometimes like to push up here. If you stand in this doorway correctly, you can get stickies onto this platform without being seen by the sentry, which is another reason to have a sentry gun perhaps down here. That's something to experiment with. A sentry gun down there would protect from this window. There aren't too many other locations for sentry guns, maybe here, but that's easily spammed out. On offense, again, your heavy's going to want to use the cart as much as he can for cover. Definitely Uber, so you can push the cart through here and get rid of any spam. The sniper is probably going to be sitting right here in this doorway, counter-sniping. Try to keep your scouts, your lighter classes, your pyro, your engineer pushing the cart. Engineer should be trying to lay down a counter-mini sentry or whatever, just so the red team can't push out onto you guys too far. Get your gear fully up. Make sure you have a teleporter out here somewhere, either in this corner or right here is a common location for both of those, for both a teleporter and a dispenser. Sorry, again, I'm just tying up all my words. That's really about it. You've got a health pack right here, which is usually spammed out before you can get to it, so if you run for that, it's usually a suicide mission. Utilize the upper area. If you're on blue, try to keep that upper, that high ground advantage, and try not to get spammed out before you get spammed out again. Blue, I'm sorry, but it's really just a death match at that point. Just really trying to outfight the red team, because they're going to be very well situated in here and ready for a long fight. Especially with the resupply cabinet being right here. For them, it's not as hard as it is for you. And now I'm just drawing it out, so I'm going to go ahead and wrap it up. Again, I'm coaching. If you guys want me to watch your games, let me know through the YouTube comments or on the eXtv page. leave me messages. I will be taking a short break during the UGC off-season, but if you want a map covered, feel free to message me, and I will probably have time to make it anyways, or cover it anyways, so just let me know. That's really about it. Good luck to all the teams this week in the playoffs, and I will be seeing you around. Moose, signing out.